Welcome to What's Cookin' in Columbia City. And there's my co-host, the one and only John Yasutake. For those of you that may not know, I'm Brenda Charles Edwards, the host of Seniors Matter on Friday afternoon at 12:30 p.m. I look forward to having you tune in to watching me. All right, John, you're up.
Well, thank you. I am co-host with Brenda Charles Edwards. As she mentioned, she does have a show, Seniors Matter. And I have a show called Seattle Here and Now, which airs every Thursday, 6 to 7, live. Brenda also has, well, like I said, she goes 12:30 to 1 p.m. live on Rainier Avenue Radio .world Seniors Matter. And what we've come to find out, she's one of the few shows that deals with subjects and matters dealing in affecting and impacting and in the interests of seniors, which is very good. So, and being a senior myself, I think that's really good. So we're waiting for our guest, Tina Albro. I hope she can make it.
Do you want to say a little bit about Tina?
Yeah. Tina is a local product. She's, grew up in the neighborhood. Tina Garrick Albro. And, she is the illustrious spouse of Tom Albro, who was with the Seattle Port Commission, the chair of the Port Commission, etc. But Tina has been, her artwork, I wish I could, I just got the word that we may not be able to show it, but you can go online to look for her art. It's just amazing. Great stuff. And so hopefully she can sign in and get on, but I wanted to highlight her and Brenda and I talked about it because she is a local artist, but much of her work is being shown in Columbia City at the Columbia City, art gallery there, right in Columbia City. She'll also be doing a project in Columbia City, decorating one of the edifices, the wall, with a mural. So it all fits the fact that she basically calls Columbia City and Rainier Avenue, well, this area, her home. And so I have a nice, real, unique art piece that she gave me, and it's the number 7 Rainier.
It's the bus or just the signage?
No, the bus. She drew it out.
Okay.
It says number 7 Rainier on it. And it was really, because she said that's what she rode, she knows what the buses are. It's number 7. That's our main bus. It goes straight down Rainier. And, so I thought that was really cool. And I have it framed and everything, matted and framed.
Do you? Yeah. Is it in your office?
Yes. Well, not here, but in my bedroom. So.
I guess that's your office.
Well, it's my other office because I'm always taking a nap. Anyways.
But happens when you get that age, John.
Yes, I know. I know. I have to keep my dog company, too. He naps with me. But anyways, I listened to the program today at the Holgate Church of Christ. It was very good. They had Ray Witherspoon, Bishop Ray Witherspoon, keynote speaker. Josie Howe performed.
Oh, nice.
It was really good. Very uplifting. And, it was, like I said, it's one of those things, 55 years. It's hard to believe that it's been that long, 55 years since the assassination of Dr. King, April 4th, 1968. And what I tell people is I'm old enough to remember the assassination of John F. Kennedy, the assassination of Malcolm X, the assassination of Robert Kennedy, and then, of course, Reverend Martin Luther King. But even before then, Medgar Evers, you know, Edwin Pratt, locally here in Seattle. So, you know, these are points in history that, as a person, you grow up, you say, I'll never forget what I was doing that day. Mm-hmm. I'll never forget all of those. I was at Garfield High School when John F. Kennedy, that's Reverend Minister, Pastor Jimmy Hurd, there's Bishop Ray Witherspoon. Then you'll have you'll see Josie perform. You can catch this again. It's good. You can get the replay of it because and there's Josie right there. Yes. But it's kind of hard to believe 55 years. And unfortunately, some things have changed, but not a whole lot. It's
they've gotten worse, actually, John.
Yeah, when you think about that, there's our mayor, Bruce Harrell. You think of all the effort, and literally the blood, sweat, and tears, and all the enlightenment, and all the things that have been done to focus on issues of equity, fairness, civil rights, etc. And these are the things that Dr. King stood for. And yet and still, it's a subject matter of discussion even now, as we, you know, just talking right now about it. And, you know, inequities, inequities in employment, inequities in living situations, homes, housing, education, legal system, you know, juvenile justice, the adult justice system, all of that is, it's just, like I said, it's almost like time has stopped and nothing's been achieved. But yeah, to some degree, they have. There have been laws passed.
But there's states that are trying to change those laws and put it back the way it was. Exactly. I mean, look what just happened in Florida.
Yeah.
With the guns.
Yeah.
I mean, my goodness. Do we really need all this? But it's okay that kids get shot in school.
Yeah, I know.
Of course, it hasn't happened to any of those people in power, to their families.
Right.
So I wonder if it ever does happen. I hope it doesn't. But if it ever does happen, will they have a different attitude, or will they think it's all about the money still?
Yeah, that's the interesting thing. We're still waiting for Tina. I just sent her the link, so I hope she's okay with the connection. We'll see, but that's why I always, like you recommend, test it before.
Yes.
Because it's important. But I did send it to her back then, and then I also sent it to her today to make sure she got it. So hopefully she'll be able to come on.
So John,
Who's
coming on next week? John somebody, right?
Yeah, John Obiska. I hope I pronounced it right. OBK from Pagliacci Pizza. That's I will say that. I can pronounce that correct. Pagliacci's Pizza. He's the manager of the Columbia City store. And, you know, Pagliacci Pizza is a local company, here in this area. And he is the manager of the Columbia City store. And right there on the corner of Hudson and... is it Hudson?
Hudson and Rainier.
No, it's not Hudson. It's I think Ferdinand and Rainier. I think Ferdinand and Rainier. Isn't it? Yeah.
That's close enough.
Yeah, it's Kitty Corner from Geraldine's. It's Kitty Corner from the Columbia. Well, across the street from the Columbia florist, Lottie Mott's is right across the street. Yeah. And we're right across the street in the middle of the block next to Tutabella. So we're right in the neighborhood. And I don't mind confessing, I've been by and gotten a piece of pizza or so, or two, or three, or four, or whatever. You know, pizza, it's a good pizza.
Well, they delivered pizza to us at school today.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm. Had a really nice salad, too.
That's good. Well, that's really good. Oh, man, I hope.
Don't sweat it. Just
keep check talking. With Dan. Anything yet shaking with respect to our guest, Tina?
Nope.
Uh-oh. So maybe anyhow. So, and in the future, I'm hoping again, like I said, we may have to do a couple of shifts with respect to one of our guests. Like I said, maybe do a recording and play that, not live, although I like doing things live. That's important. But we've got just a whole number of businesses that I'm going to be, and you've been making contacts. It was great having Bull and Flo on.
Mm-hmm. Yes, I saw them today, as a matter of fact. Yeah,
very good. And hopefully we get Tina on, but then next week we are going to have Pagliacci Pizza come on. And we've done everything from hairdressers to pizza parlor barbecue. Coming, barbecue, home site, you know, what's the best way to describe sheltered living? Not sheltered living, but, you know, affordable housing, mm-hmm. home site. We've had a real eclectic shop. I like shopping there, Andalus. Carla, right. I mean, they got nice stuff. I got this really nice smelling incense that I bought from her. It was really good. Andalus. Hopefully we'll get her next door neighbor, Taproots. And like I said, we've been through the realm and making contact. Love to get PCC on. I've been there and talked to their manager. And I think it's just a matter of time. And of course, we have a real strong connection. And we've worked.
Don't forget Theo. We had Theo
Island Soul, and he's just now opened up his shop in Kirkland, and it's a little bit different cuisine, but it got good reviews from what I saw. So hey, that's one there. But like I said, we've got you. If you want to get a haircut, you go to Rudy's. If you want to get a pizza, you go to Pagliacci's. If you want to get a coffee, you go to the Olympic Brewery or whatever, the Olympic Brew. There's a couple of coffee places. If you want to shop for groceries, go to PCC. If you want pet food and everything like that, you can go to all the best. We got Bob's Meats, and they make some great sausage. Boy, their hot links, oh my God, it's really good. I'm putting these plugs out there. But we've got, like I said, everything from soup to nuts, everything from A to Z. And right. We got locksmiths. We've got, again, if you want to work out, you got Bull and Flo, catch up to them. If you want to read something, we got the Columbia City Library, you know, right there.
And if you want, if you have a project and you need to make copies, you've got the copy.
Copy, right. Right. And we've got a number of businesses that do tailoring a little bit farther down, but real close. And like I said, we've got a whole, I love to say this word, a plethora of businesses that we can call. We got a veterinarian hospital, as well as veterinarian office. And of course, we got the old standby rookies. And when we change our broadcast time, we'll be able to get somebody from rookies to come on, because 9:30 is a little late. But, you know, I'm a night owl, so you know what the heck. And I just made a new pot of coffee, so I'm going to be drinking that. But, you know, gosh, I'm hoping everything's okay with Tuna. I'm really, she is an outstanding artist. I've got to get her back. I'm going to get her on when we get a chance. But you've been making contact. And I know we talked about, we've kind of expanded a little bit because we've got Kinon, which is basically a retirement home catering to older members of the Asian community. And then also we've got Emma's, like I said, we had Emma's on, and she's really expanding. She's going to be at Lumen Field, correct?
She's already there. She has two locations there.
Oh my gosh. Great for her.
Yes, it is.
Yes. Like I said, a little bit. And we've had Off Alley. I haven't had a chance to go there, but every time I go by there, there's people standing outside waiting to get in. Off Alley, yes. Off Alley, which is a good sign.
pick a day that's not raining.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's not raining. And of course, again, Lottie's. I went by Lottie's and I saw that they had to replace their door. I don't know what happened, but yeah, there was a big piece of plywood stuck on the front door, and I think it's been, yeah, they put their glass in, so they're good to go. But they're another place that we want to invite to come in and appear. So, you know, like I said, we've got a number of businesses, like I said, nearly 200, over 100 plus. We can get, like I said, you can get anything from soup to nuts. So other than that, getting back to the programming, we will be talking, ladies and gentlemen, those of you who are with us, talking about changing our program hour. So when we get a chance to put our heads together, Brenda, I mean, speaking of heads, you're around them little kids with pointed heads over there at Rainier Beach High School. Whenever we get a chance, we got to put our heads together, not pointed, not like them, but our heads together and find a more suitable time for us. Even though, you know, 9:30 ain't too late, but it's not prime. It's not considered prime time, but, you know, like, so yet any thoughts on that, about what time you would prefer? 7-ish, 8-ish?
Yes, 7-ish would be better.
Mm-hmm.
And just a matter of what I talked to Daniel about this a little bit the other day, and it's just a matter of finding what slot works not only for us but works for him too.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Right.
Since he is our producer, who's the producer extraordinaire, so we have to make it work for him too.
Correct. That's right, because he's it. He's our producer. He's our tech. He's our
he's our everything.
Yeah, our everything. He's everything.
Sound us. Effects.
And yeah, sound effects. And he's also our conscience and all that good stuff. And you got to meet Linda, a beautiful, beautiful creature. Look, a beautiful cat, Linda. I watch him with Linda. We have staff meeting. I see Linda. Yeah, she's okay. Really cute, you know. Anyway, so we've got a bunch of stuff coming up. Shoot, we're going to doggone it. I'm sorry we missed Tina, because like I said, her art is just, I love it. It's really outstanding.
And so do you know what type of mural she's going to be painting?
I don't know yet. That's what I invited her to come on tonight to talk about the project that she's going to be doing, you know, when the weather gets better, you know, not rainy and stuff like that, but it'll be a major project. Oh, there's
Linda. That Linda?
Yeah.
Hi, beautiful. Linda.
Yeah, be a beautiful cat. Wow, you know, look at that. Yeah. So anyway, she was going to talk. Well, I'm going to get her on. We're going to get her on one way or the other, by hook or by crook. Because like I said, I love her art. And I missed her on my show, and I'm sorry I missed her for our show tonight. So, you know.
So I read that she grew up in the neighborhood, the Rainier Valley neighborhood, mm-hmm. and that her artwork comes from her experiences in living in Rainier Valley,
mm-hmm.
which I thought was interesting. And mm-hmm. yes, it would be interesting to hear what some of her experiences are and how she was able to transpose those into works of art.
Yeah, well, like I said, I have one of her originals. It's a print, but it's of the Seven Rainier that she mm-hmm. says she wrote all every day. And I'm saying, oh my gosh, you're relating to things that people in the community know. I don't know of anybody who hasn't ridden on the Seven Rainier at least once in their life. I know that's true. Mm-hmm. And So, you know, that's really interesting. And she's got some other things that are really outstanding. But anyway, that's that. But speaking of upcoming things, you got a show Friday upcoming. Mm-hmm. Any hints as to who you're going to have guest-wise?
It's still in the planning stage, although I'll put it out there, and hopefully if he's listening, he'll say, yes, I'd love to do that. No, but you know our friend Mark.
Mm-hmm.
And I would like to do a show with Mark, even if it's not this week, but
mm-hmm.
I'd like to do a show with him. Well, we did one a couple years ago, but now that we're in the studio and he's got the front section, mm-hmm. I'd like to do where he does exercises for seniors.
That was great.
And
I remember when you did that, right?
Yeah, but this time there's more space, and there's Mark.
Yeah. And that's perfect
more
because
space. And
yeah,
I might
even
participate in the exercises. I don't know yet. We'll see.
Oh my gosh.
But, you know, which is a little different than what we normally do. But Mark has been training seniors mm-hmm. for a long time now at the Southeast Seattle Senior Center on how to exercise and move carefully. So, Mark, if you're listening, I'm going to be calling you. So don't turn me down.
Yeah, don't turn her down. For me, on Thursday, which would be the 6th of April, we're already mm-hmm. almost in the second, going to the second half. Seattle here and now, I'm going to have Joy Hollingsworth on. A declared candidate for position district number 2.
Oh, really?
Seattle City Council. But we are not doing a show about that's politicized. I'm going to have her introduce herself to the community, you know, where she grew up, where she went to school. She, you know, has an outstanding educational background, master's degree, etc., in some of the best schools. But also, she was a great athlete, basketball.
Oh, really?
At Seattle Prep. And of course, she's the granddaughter of Dorothy Hollingsworth, a pioneering woman.
Oh, yes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And first African American on the Seattle School Board, active in the sorority. I think, I hope I'm right. She's not Delta. I think it was AKA. Is it AKA?
I don't know.
Oh, okay. I got to be careful.
Yeah, please don't say the wrong one.
Yes. She's in a
sorority.
She's a soror, and activist in the community, and knew your mom, of course, and your family, and my family, my in-laws too. I mean, my in-laws, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So, great, just a great lady, Dorothy, and so I think it comes naturally that Joy is putting her, you know, setting her foot into the pool. Whatever pool that is. And like I said, going to make a run for Seattle City Council. And it's curious because she's going for Sawant's position.
Mm-hmm.
And Sawant hadn't declared anything. So everyone assumed Sawant was going to go for reelection. And the day, I think it's the day or a few days after Joy declared her candidacy for the position, our friend Sawant said, oh, I'm not running. And I think she realized which way the wind was going to be blowing.
Right.
Because I have to be very honest to the community that I have knowledge about and have connections to, which is our central area community, parts of Capitol Hill, etc. There's not a whole lot of
support.
There's not a lot of affinity for Sawant because they're asking the same question. Where have you been? You're a single issue person. You're a socialist. You're anti-business, that kind of stuff. And I'm not trying to slam her.
No,
I don't want to get in trouble. But, however, that's what others are saying. Not John. Not moi. Others. Thank you. I just want to make that perfectly clear.
Yes, thank you for clearing that up, sir.
Yeah, right. Well, I won't get the phone call. Daniel or Tony will. But anyway, so that's what's coming up on Thursday for me. And yeah, it looks like we're going to be wrapping up right here. Unfortunately, we missed Tina. I hope everything's okay with her. Like I said, she was sick. She sounded terrible, too.
Oh, sorry and, to hear that.
Yeah. And yeah. So we are going to be back next week with who? Who we have coming?
John.
J-O-N.
Yes.
Obrisk, I think is how you pronounce it. From who?
The pizza place.
What's the name of the pizza place? Co-host?
Polly. Polly.
Pagliacci. Pronounce it correctly.
Pagliacci.
Pizza, yes. Very good. So, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and all the ships at sea, I'm going to be bidding you adieu. Au revoir, sayonara, goodbye, see you later, alligator. We will be on next week with, again, like I said, our show with John Obrick. I'm going to have to learn how to pronounce it. I'm going to ask him how to pronounce his name. From Pagliacci Pizza, again, this is me, John Yasutake, your co-host with my co-host.
Charles Edwards of Seniors Matter. You guys have a great evening. Yep. We'll see you next week.
And we'll be on next week on What's Cookin', Columbia City. Bye. Have a great evening, y'all.
You too, John.
You too. Don't let them kids.